So today is the 6th of July and I am sitting here watching the match between Sri Lanka and India, the cricket match between Sri Lanka and India. So I thought, why not try and finish reading this nonsense while I have entertainment on the side. MasterChef Australia works usually, but I need to listen to that. This I don't need to listen to. I can just watch and then I can do my thing on the side. Please ignore any background noises that are coming. It could be from the kitchen, it could be from the road, anywhere. Hey, wait, you just said that you are weak and an easy target. Okay, what was that? Oh God, I confused. I'm not joking. The actual sentence is I confused. I wish someone could tell her that she was contracting herself, but no one did. She is a disease or what to contract herself. It's contradicting you. It seems last week also I had heard the same words, but poor Diya still had not suffered Preeti's fury. Bad idea to actually do this. She asks him, do you think I'm wrong? And this fellow is thinking. I thought for a moment, not analyzing what happened, but thinking of the answer I gave last time as proving her wrong and guilty. That sentence does not make sense. The spelling of proving is wrong. P-R-O-V-I-N-G is the spelling. It's not P-R-O-O-V-I-N-G. Why did you say it? Could have gone for a 4. Okay. But back to this. P-R-O-O-V-I-N-G is wrong. But then I was questioned and asked to give justification with evergreen lines. She did not ask for evergreen lines. I expected a cute smile from her after I finished and a cute line from her. Cute. Why is it always cute smile? She punched me and smiled in her cute way. Simmer kept on shouting at everyone and warning me again and again that he would leave me. He's your boyfriend. There's no mention of Simmer, Varun and this fellow, whatever this guy's name is, sitting in the back of the cab together. But suddenly Varun and this fellow are looking at each other, they're smiling, and then suddenly, oh man, I'm sorry, this fellow said, and then hugged him. Hugged whom? Simmer. You didn't even tell us he was sitting with you. It was a nice moment where we three expressed our feeling for each other. Wow. This is not fair. I want to ... What? Where to open the apostrophes? Where to close them? You have no idea, right? You need to go to school again. You need to take English as a course again so that you can understand how to form sentences, how to use grammar and punctuation in a way that people will understand. At least get it edited if you don't want to edit it yourself. But the first rule of being an author is you need to edit your own work at least twice before sending it off to someone else. Shell shocked is a very extreme form of shock. So you can't just use it in a place where Simmer turned away ignoring her and then she was shell shocked. Come on, if she was the one who was ignoring him and not talking properly with him, then she shouldn't be shell shocked. Surprised or shocked is enough. He avoided her brilliantly, it seems. What's so brilliant about avoiding? There's nothing great about it. There's nothing brilliant about it. He avoided her well. He's also fine. That adjective does not fit there. She offered me the same and we started to converse. I immediately shifted my glance. Why immediately? Kuch hone wala tha. I immediately shifted my glance and noticed her soft right hand slightly placed on her thigh. I guess she was still staring at me. Even if you're looking somewhere else, in peripheral vision, you will understand if that person is staring at you or not. I told Simmer about it. He could hardly control himself, desperate to talk to her. The long wait was over as she called Simmer and they both went out. There's nothing to suggest that the long wait was over. And even if it is, it's sort of all mutilated, like you don't know what to put first. How difficult is that?
So I'm back with a shitty book, and I have about 15 minutes before I need to go and work on something else. So let's get on with this. Let's see how much I can do within these 15 minutes. Apostrophe. We will go to Mumbai tomorrow. Full stop. Apostrophe close. Simmer asked me. How is that a question? You tell me how that's a question. I want to know. Just seriously. She's smart, futable. So I need to try and understand and make out from this one that you are an extremely intelligently witty person who can make like jokes about language that you don't know. I am not, but you are an insane pig. What insult, bro? When Puneet insulted like this, saying that, but I am not, but you are an insane pig, Vikas shouted, why did you use my soap today? That's not even a counter insult, dude. You need to understand. And then stop watching my TV, ... no space, you asshole. Oh god, they started again, Varun expressed. After a few minutes of fighting, they all got back to their routine work, and that was to prepare dinner. Okay, but they all made me think about Riya. They technically did not make you think about Riya. When Simmer asked you to go with him to Mumbai, you said that you have a date planned out with Riya. So it's you. Don't blame them. Yes, I was concentrating hard on her. The way she talked, how she laughed, her smiles, her tears, her behavior, everything about her was charming. Why do you need to say, yes, I was concentrating on her, hard on her? Hard? Concentrating hard? Really? Look at a guy describing a girl's dress. I saw her standing in her light yellow top with a floral design. She was looking hot in her goggles with loose hair and watching me coming from the parking. Light yellow top with floral design. Like, we don't have any other designs only. Light yellow top, floral design, and she was looking hot. Hotness is very important, huh? For guys, I don't know. Like, loose hair is symbolic of hotness for some weird reason. I have no idea why. But with a glance at her wristwatch and before I could say anything, she sparked. What did she spark? She spark plug, huh? To spark, keep sparking. Thinking hard of valid reasons but could think of nothing right then, and she fired again. Stop using fired. It's not the correct usage in this situation. You've been using this throughout the book, and this is another place where it's not supposed to be used. This girl is getting angry because he always makes her late. Because he's always late. 15 minutes this time. And she's just telling him that he's being irresponsible. And look at this idiot fellow's way of giving her a compliment and trying to soften her up. Wow, you're looking damn hot, I said, hoping that my compliment might work as a fire extinguisher. I always order whenever we go out. Okay, you should learn to order. Girls like men leading rather than being led. Feminist icon of the century she is. Or the exact opposite. She tells him that he should have more chicken, but he says, you know I am a vegetarian. To which this idiot woman responds, I know, it's okay, I can't force you. I will order something veg for you. She resented. You know what's the meaning of resentment. You know what's the meaning of resentment. If you don't know the meaning of words, don't use it. Or if you want to learn the meaning of such words, or if you want to use the words, then at least Google them. It's not that difficult to Google them and know what a word is about before using them in your writing. Again, cute. How cute she was looking. Glittering eyes, tremendous beauty. Oh, I just loved her. Hey, you know, I have also never tried before, my stupid lover boy. Is that the way someone talks? Really? I don't know when, suddenly while talking to her, I held her hand tightly and stared at her with my eyes full of love for her. She also didn't try to take her hand away. Instead, she tilted her neck sideways, bit her lip, and her brown, deep, innocent eyes flashed into mine. How do eyes flash into eyes? Asking about my views, looking at the dresses of other girls, their partners, and so on. This is not a project paper that if you can say that I did. I don't even know what example to give you. I wanted her to get fume and stop talking to me, allowing me to convince her, pacify her, and give her the warmth I could, but that all was in my mind. I wanted her to fume is a different thing. I wanted her to get fume means you want her to suffocate and die. Yeah? I'm interpreting it like that. I excused myself and went somewhere and asked her to wait there only. I could feel the feeling of disappointment was still there in her. Wow. Feel the feeling of disappointment. Wow. This is so creepy. She started to move as per my directions and after a few steps, I patted her from behind. Hey, creep-ass fellow. Tapped on her shoulder would be a better usage. What the hell is wrong with you? She was a bit shocked to see me bringing flower for her. With a sudden change in her expressions from blue to stormy. And within few seconds to a cheerful one. What? What is this, Ray? See me bringing flower for her. With a sudden change in her expressions from blue to stormy. Hey. Just close your eyes, I said. Why? Surprise? As in? She expressed and closed her eyes. Arre, what is this expressed, dude? It doesn't fit anymore. She was excited to see the small kit of chocolates. Box is fine, no? Why do you have to use kit for that? Okay, I can't do this anymore today. I'm done for today. I can't take it. Bye. So today is the 31st of July and I realized today that I have been reading this book for close to 6 months now because I started this in February and it's still not over. I can't believe myself. I'm at 68% and let's see. It says 24 minutes left in the book, but given my annoyance with it, I don't think 24 minutes is going to be a thing. Anyway, let's just get this over with. I apologize for upsetting her and she asked me not to behave formally. First of all, this girl, she gets angry at every little thing. And when he apologizes, she asks him not to behave formally. What nonsense is this? I was brought back by Rhea from the valley of sudden emotion that filled me at that time unknowingly. Controlling myself, I got up smiling looking at her. What nonsense. We moved out. Not even we left the hotel or we left the cafe. We moved out. And after walking few steps, we reached the bus stop. She was looking here and there. And abruptly pointed out at the board nearby which advertised the salsa classes to be taken by some celebrity trainer. You have no idea how much I'm controlling myself. Wow, I want to learn salsa, she said, jumping in excitement as if she had got selected to participate in Nach Baliye. She wants to learn. She was not accepted into the dance academy, into the class. How can I forget when Preeti compelled me trickily to join salsa with her, throwing emotional tantrums on me? Most of all, she got attracted towards the kiss at the end of every class that she would give me? ? This is the grossest description of salsa I've ever seen.
I did join the class with her, though I hardly got any kiss after the class, but we learned to shake our bodies with the dance beats. You think that is what salsa is all about? Shaking body, that's what dance is all about. She stated like an eager student who wanted to join a new class under physics professor. What?
From where did physics professor come?
She said, tilting her neck sideways with right index finger between her teeth. If you thought that was sensual, that's exactly the opposite. Stupid, you will do salsa alone, full stop. She giggled. I looked here and there just to steal my eyes from the strange looks that came my way. What? How will you steal your eyes from the strange looks? And that you are looking around. I held her hand and that moved me when I felt velvet-like touch so soft. The wind blew her hair and I felt it too and that made me forget everything. What is your problem, dude? This is ridiculous. She wants them to dance. Do a salsa dance, you know, to word song. Aaja piya to hai pyar do, gori bhaiya to pe waar do. That's a slow song. I mean, maybe trained salsa dancers can do that, but you doing it in the middle of the road, being described by an author who doesn't know grammar and punctuation is the most ridiculous thing I've ever read about. I was instructing her to move forward and then take a step back and so on. Wow, so beautiful description of salsa dance. We continued to entertain people for just few seconds. When I pulled off, what did you pull off, Ray? And pointed out that it was getting late as we had missed the bus. Okay. She jumped and laughed in excitement and then I took an auto back to my place after dropping her at Vishalnagar where she was staying. Ray, she... This is called abrupt. This. My heartbeat should pace up while thinking of her. But still Preeti was not leaving. Even the void created by her absence was not getting filled up. If Preeti is not leaving, then how is there a void created by her absence? She was wearing a light yellow long frock just like white fairy dress with hair loose and smiling at me, she responded. Well, I can be anywhere for my lover boy. Apostrophe close. Then next apostrophe open. Oh dear, I really miss you. Please come back. I will become something soon. Just give me some more time, I pleaded. What? It's just that your dreams sometimes cling to the facts around you. Your head. I don't know if this fellow's trying to make fun of people or if he's trying to act over smart, but look at, someone gave these two idiots a lift and that driver says, show guys, where do you work? You think that's funny? If the rest of your book made sense, then I would probably take this as just another character quirk. But if you are talking like this, I guess you guys are late. What will you do now? For a moment he went quiet and then he burst into laughter. Okay, surprisingly makes sense. The girl at the front seat smiled and seeing her, Simar laughed loudly, getting excited. Tharki, that's called being tharki. Hey guys, nice meeting you. I am Anant Khanna, senior head from recruitment team and from your company. See you guys in office. Take care. Smiling, he went off in a flash. Someday someone should make fun of the way you talk. Okay. And then you'll understand probably. What is this nonsense? Maybe come in, sir. Like there are legitimately there are 5 R's here on the sir. The whole class was now staring at us and many were trying to press their laughter and funny smile on seeing us as if we were jokers. Press their laughter. Suppress their laughter, Ray. Again he looked at Simmer abruptly. No other work this fellow has. No, sir. He means. If you are trying to portray hesitation, that does not make sense. I said getting fluttered. Simmer bumbled. He asked getting calm. Getting calm. And he turned towards us and shouted, you too. Just move in and next time I guess you won't be late. That's called shouting. What a
lame.
Basics. Basic. I can't even hit my head with this. This might break. We apologize and moved in. Now they'll be living in the conference room. They're moving in with their furniture and all. Simmer on the other side was still on the other side, not in on the other hand. Simmer on the other side was still trying to cultivate the harmonious feelings in Sonal. You're trying to have a romantic relation or India-Pakistan relations you're trying to repair? The lamest of the lame pickup lines here. Is there any airport around? Simmer asked Sonal. No. Then why is my heart ready to take off? Riya paced up to check if Sonal was fine. Paced up? I guess I noticed a different friend with me. Your head. Every time Riya and I were be together. My favorite Ranbir Kapoor is on screen again. Yippee. She added. I will search and let you know the timings and then we can fix a program. He's talking about looking for movie tickets. And for that she replies, wow, you are smart. And she starts singing that song from, I don't remember which movie that was. Katrina Kaif and Ranbir Kapoor. Tera Hone Laga Hoon. The English chorus. It seems a nice song, na? She asked. Yes, yes, very nice, he said. And then we hung up after deciding to call in the evening. So man, Puneet says, so man, this time movie. Great man, he said, removing his earphones. I regret the day that I decided to read this book. A guy was being chopped. She would have thrashed me and the crowd here would have witnessed the best drama in which a guy was being chopped for forgetting movie tickets. Yeah. I never feel my beat right when you get angry. You're a stupid beetroot. This is not even childish writing. Children write better than you. They are more creative. Language wise I'm talking about. If the language was good, I would have been like, okay, it was an easy breezy read, but this is horrible. Putting some corns into my mouth, that's gross. Shahid Karina's lip lock and she pinched my arm, pressing my hand tightly. She kept her head on my shoulder and I was feeling her warmth and care. How do you... God, why did you create me? They love each other and they keep asking, how was your day, lover boy? No, I mean, I hope you enjoyed yourself with me. Of course I loved it. Hey, pretty, did you enjoy yourself with me? She raised her right hand and softly placing it on my left cheek, moved her lips close to my face and kissed me. I loved it when you bought corns for me. Corns. This is, you need to think logically for a second, okay? Chronologically, logically, both. Riya and I decided to meet at E Square for our favorite Ranbir Kapoor movie. If the movie is just out and it's in cinemas right now, how can she already have it as her favorite Ranbir Kapoor movie? She inquired, tying her loose hair with the band in between her teeth and looking through her glasses at me. Postures described so horribly, so damn horribly. She would laugh at his joke and crossing her legs, she would keep her elbow on her right thigh chin, supported with her hand upright and staring at Ranbir like a mad lover. I wanted her to laugh wholeheartedly, make comparisons, disturb me, ask me, pop up and down on her seat. She's popcorn or what? To pop up and down on seat. Why was I taking the film so critically? How do you take films critically, dude? And then placing my left hand on her right cheek, I moved my lips near her soft glowing cheek just to feel the wondrous silky touch and thanked her for being with me. She smiled and then turned her look outside. Okay, so you moved your lips, like you moved it like this and then you put it there. And then she turned her look outside, like she did this. Inside out she turned it. Ria, I called her name like never before, getting close to her ear, whispering softly with all the intense feelings I could. Biting her lower lip, okay, she turned towards me, okay, and adjusting her hair blown by the wind. The girls in this book don't have any other work. Their hair is always being blown by the wind. With her right hand, she gave a magnetic smile. Magnetic. And then asked me to close my eyes. Simmer at once changed his expression to a pale, off-colored person with eyes showing his weakness. He kept his mouth open to show how out of breath he was after such an illness. Oh God, save me. Save me, please. May we come in, sir? What idiots these people are. The trainer keeps asking the same question again and again and these people give the different response. Ek bar, if they said that Simmer got food poisoning because of vada pav, can't they remember that they told that? Three times, three different. Once vada pav, once dal makhni and once kadi pakora. What nonsense. I'm not saying it has to be realistic. I'm just saying that it's like nobody is that stupid. We got ready, came down and he kicked his splendor. And we paced towards the sacred place. This resulted in his facing the wrath of his loving girlfriend, oops, fiance. I could very well imagine his situation as he was handling it perfectly, stating some valid lies. That trying to confuse her and finally he was successful before he faced another round of her anger when he said that he was going to Hollywood Gurudwara with me. What? Such a long ass sentence. Doesn't even make sense. You don't have grammar, punctuation, no commas, no semicolons, nothing. You could have cut this into three sentences, but no. After all, they had both promised each other to be together, so still an emotional glitch was teasing him from inside of breaking the promise. What do you want to say? Still an emotional glitch was teasing him from inside of breaking the promise. What do you want to say? You tell me now. The slide moved, but I was stuck with those lines conveying the deep meaning, it seems. Stuck. She was coming with her mother near my residence when she pondered over the chance of meeting me. You gave me the wrong address, you fiend. The fiend is the word that she's using for him giving her the wrong address. He didn't even give her the wrong address. She got lost. Her lips, which were constantly fluttering. Watch his butterfly. I was really feeling divine with her. Ray. Lover boy was just left wondering the punctuality of her mother and the interruption as if she sensed her daughter being loved at a nearby place. Ugh. Yuck. Ugh. He was looking stunning in her yellow shorts and black silky top with her loose wet hair. I entered and looked at the very well furnished and clean rooms, unlike ours, rooms untidy and withered walls with plaster on walls, that too showing various figures changing every day. You call her pretty and then when she fumes, you could not resist asking her the reason. How dense do you have to be? The steps matched perfectly, hands in hands. The next step where I held her left hand upright and she rotated like a doll with her right hand placed at the back. Everybody was enjoying and an element of separation after the allocation was in their mind too, but still the celebrations were on. she was looking into my eyes and I was feeling her beauty and I could feel her beauty. How does that make sense? That's her problem. How cute she was looking. How is it that the most beautiful chapter of my life was closed with a never-ending conclusion? If the chapter ended, then how is it a never-ending conclusion? I was smiling inside seeing the trio of engaged, committed, married. I was analyzing my journey to Pune and my last few months. The siren was loud and clear and I bid goodbye to Pune inside closing my eyes. And as I looked at the perfect figure standing and inquiring about the seat. That's your problem. She gave a strong look through her glasses. What do you mean by strong look? Finished it. I finished this bunch of crap. This is so horrible, such a horrible book. The language is horrible. There's no grammar and punctuation. There's nothing unusual about it. This fellow has come from Jalandhar to Pune. Okay? For training a different job. He's trying to forget his ex-girlfriend, Preeti. He falls in love with Riya, but he still thinks about Preeti. When Riya proposes to him, he says he can't be in love with her, he can't do this, he can't do that. And then when Riya, out of nowhere, Riya's father and mother are separated and she's moving to the US. And then he decides that he's not going to love again. And when he's going to Greater Noida, where he has been given his, where he has been transferred, he meets a girl on the train with perfect figure. Always. These people always describe us like that. It's like they don't see anything else. And then he is like, all my declarations about not falling in love, they're all nonsense. And I'm going to try my luck with this lady. What I'm relieved the most about is that 5.5 months of torture, like I didn't do this in continuity, but whenever I read it, it was complete torture. And now knowing that I no longer have to do this because I brought this upon myself. I found a shitty book and I started reading it even though I knew how it was going to be. It was a shitty book after all. So I'm not going to mention the name of the book, but know that I was very tortured by it. And maybe if you DM me, I can tell you about it, but not on a public platform. Even though I just ranted on a public platform about a book. But yes, that's how I work.